Good morning, dear students. Welcome for today's video lecture of maths. In today's lecture, we are going to learn four concepts. In that, we are going to learn standard form of rational numbers. Then we are going to learn comparison of rational numbers, absolute value of rational numbers, and then in the last, we will learn the representation of rational numbers on the number line. Though there are four concepts, they are very short and easy to understand. Why? Because all those concepts we have learned in the case of fraction. Okay, so it's going to be easy for you. Pay attention, little changes there. Okay, see, first, standard form of rational numbers. Okay, in the learning the chapter fraction, we have learned the standard form means what? You know, standard form means what? Finding the lowest term. Lowest means smallest. Finding the smallest term of the fraction. Similarly, here in the case of rational number, we are going to find the lowest term of the given rational number. Okay? But before finding that lowest term, first step we have to follow is that is if denominator is negative. Listen very carefully. If denominator is negative, first we have to make it positive. Means denominator we have to make positive, and then we have to go move towards finding lowest term. Okay, so how to make the denominator positive if it is negative? If it is negative, now in the first example, see here 45 upon minus 70. So to make this denominator positive, what we do, this negative sign we give to the numerator. Okay, finish. Negative sign give to the numerator. Means it was first the denominator, give to the numerator. It's okay because this negative sign, though it is in front of denominator, it is the sign of whole fraction or whole rational number. Okay, so you can write it either in front of denominator or numerator or before the whole, that fraction. It's okay. So what we have done to make this denominator positive, this negative sign we have brought up in the numerator. Fine. Now denominator is positive. Now let's move towards the finding lowest term. You know how to find the lowest term? Yes, what we have to do? We have to divide both numerator and denominator by their HCF. So what is HCF of 45 and 70? Do you know what is HCF? Highest common factor of 45 and 70? It is nothing but 5. HCF of 45 and 70 is 5. That's why we will divide both numerator and denominator, that is both 45 and 70 by 5. Okay. So you know 5, 9 is 45, that is minus 9 upon 5, 14 is 45 is 70. Okay, so the answer is minus 9 upon 14. This is a standard form of 45 upon 70. Okay, next. Minus 32 upon 48. Find the standard form. Now, as we have seen, the first step is that if denominator is negative, make it positive. Now, if you see a denominator 48, it is already positive, so not able to do anything directly. We have to divide both 32 and 48 by their HCF. What is their HCF? Highest common factor of 32 and 48 is 16, right? So divide both numbers, numerator by and for denominator by 16. 16 2s are, that is minus 2, because if there is minus 32, and 16 3s are 48. So answer is minus 2 upon 3. Next, 40 upon minus 45. Here denominator is negative, first we have to make it positive. That's why shift this negative sign in the numerator. It will become minus 40 upon 45. Okay. Now think, which is the HCF of both 40 and 45? It is 5. So divide both of them by 5. 5 8s and 5 9s. Minus 8 upon 9. So in this way, we can find the standard form of the given rational number. Okay. Write these three examples in the notebook. After that, we will see the comparison of rational numbers. Let's see the second concept, comparison of rational numbers. Okay, comparison of rational numbers. As we have seen two methods in comparison of fraction. Which those two methods are? First method is by finding the LCM and making the denominator same, equal. And second method we have learned that is by cross multiplication. Same two methods we have to use here. First method is by making denominators equal. And to make denominators equal, what we have to do? We have to find the LCM of denominators and we have to convert those denominators equal to the LCM. Okay, so see here two rational numbers are there, -8/9 and -4/-5. So first step we have to follow same step we have done in the standard form. While finding the standard form, same step we have used here. First we have to make the denominator positive if it is negative. If denominator is negative, first we have to make it positive and then we have to proceed. Now see the first -8/9, denominator is already positive, so keep it as it is. But in the second rational number, 4/-5, denominator is negative. So first we have to make it positive, and so for that shift this minus sign in the numerator. Okay. Now these two rational numbers we have and their denominators are positive. Now let us find the LCM of both 9 and 5. What is LCM of 9 and 5? LCM of 9 and 5 is 45, correct? So we have to make the denominator 45. Now see, -8/9. 9 multiplied by how many 45? 9 5 sir. That's why multiplied here also by 5. And -4/5. 5 9s are, so 4 9s are. -4 9s. So -8/5 is -40/45. And here -36/45. Okay, now denominators are same, means they are like rational numbers. That's why now we can compare their numerators to decide which is greater. Now here numerator is -40 and -36. Do you know which is greater, -40 or -36? In the -40 and -36, which is greater, -40 or -36? It's -36. Okay, -36 is greater, because if you view these numbers on the number line, -36 comes on the right side of the -40. That's why -36 is greater. Okay, that means -40/45 is less than -36/45. Understood? Okay. So in this way, we can compare the given rational numbers by finding LCM and making the denominator same. First method. See the second method. Second method is by cross multiplication. Okay, same here also. Same first step. In the first step, we have to make the denominators positive if they are negative. We have to make them positive. Now, see here 2/-3. 2/-3. Okay, so this, to make this 3 positive, they are minus sign shift in the numerator. So it will become -2/3. And here also -7 is negative, so shift this minus sign in the numerator, it will become positive. Understood? Now do the cross multiplication. On cross multiply or on cross multiplication, how to do cross multiplication? -2 means for numerator of first rational number and denominator of second rational number. -2/7. And here numerator of second rational number and denominator of first rational number. Okay. So 7/-2 is -14. Correct. And -4/3 is -12. Which is greater, -14 or -12? Again see, -12 is greater, -14 is less than -12. Okay, so that's why this sign will become less than. See now, -14 means, write this fraction, the rational number on the left side, minus 2 upon 3, is less than minus 4 upon 7. Okay? Understood? So, in this way, we have to use these two methods to compare the rational numbers. First method is by finding LCM and making denominators equal, and second method is by cross multiplication. They are very easy methods. Watch this very carefully. Okay? Now write these two methods in the example in the notes. In the comparison of rational number, one more question which is asked, that is, arrange the given rational number into ascending and descending order. Okay? It is also part of comparison, so let us learn how to arrange the given rational numbers into ascending and descending order. Same, all the steps are same here. As there are more than two rational numbers, we can use the first method, that is making denominators equal. Okay? So see here, first step is that make all the denominators positive. As usual, here denominator is already positive, here denominator is negative. So shift the subtraction sign, minus sign in the numerator. Here already denominator is positive. Okay. Now let us make the denominators equal by finding LCM. So what is LCM of 5, 15 and 3? LCM of 5, 15 and 3. What is that? Can you tell me? Yes, it is nothing but 15 itself. Okay? So, make the denominator 15. So, minus 4 upon 5. You know, 5, 3 is 15. So, here also multiply with. Here already it is 15, so not going to do anything. And here minus 2 upon 3. So, 3, 5 is 15. Okay? Now, minus 4 into 3. Minus 12 upon 15, minus 9 upon 15, and minus 5 is 10 upon 15. Okay, all the three rational numbers are with the same denominator, which is 15. Now let's arrange them into ascending order first and then descending order. Ascending order is smallest to biggest, which is smaller? Smallest rational number here. Smallest rational number is, compare the numerator, 9, minus 9, minus 12 or minus 10 is the smallest. Smallest is actually minus 12. Okay? So minus 12 upon 15 is the smallest. Then minus 10 upon 15 is one second place. And 9 upon 15. Minus 9 upon 15. You know why? Because on the number 9, minus 12 appear on the left of minus 10. Minus 10 appear on the left of minus 9. So on the number line, the integers which appear on the left, they are smallest. Okay? We have seen that. So here, this is ascending order and descending order. Exactly opposite of that. This is greater, so we will come here. Minus 9 upon 15, minus 10 upon 15, and minus 12 upon 15. Okay, that means here minus 12 upon 15 means which fraction? Minus 4 upon 5 is smaller than minus 10 upon 15 means this, minus 2 upon 3 is greater or smaller than this. Minus 9 upon 15 means this. 9 upon minus 15. Okay? And similarly here, minus 9 upon 15 means 9 upon minus 15, which is given in the question, is greater than minus 2 upon 3, greater than minus 4 upon 5. Understood? So in this way we can compare the arrange the given rational numbers into ascending or descending order. Okay? Again, write this in the see here, absolute value of rational number. Absolute value. What is mean by absolute value? We have seen that in the case of integer also and whole number also. If you remember, Absolute value means what? The distance of any integer. Let us first see about integers. Absolute value means distance of any integer from the zero. Okay? That means what? See here, if you want to talk about absolute value of this 4. Absolute value of 4. Absolute value is represented by these two vertical lines. Okay? So, absolute value of 4 will be, what is distance of this 4 from the 0. Now, if you consider this as a unit distance, okay? So, how many units are there? 1, 2, 3 and 4. From here to here, 4 units. Okay? So, absolute value of this 4 is nothing but 4. Similarly, if you want to find absolute value of this minus 4, absolute value of minus 4, what it will be? As I told you, absolute value means the distance of that integer from the 0. Okay? And you see, as you have found here, distance between 0 and 4, 4 units. Similarly here, distance of this minus 4 from 0. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many units? 4 units. So, absolute value of minus 4 is also 4. Okay? Absolute value of 4 is 4. And absolute value of minus 4 is also 4. Means every absolute value there are 2 integers. Every absolute value stands for 2 integers. Okay? 4 and minus 4. Similarly, if you absolute value of any integer is 5. Okay? 5 stands for which 2 integers? Absolute value 5 stands for which 2 integers? 5, positive 5 and negative 5. Correct? One more thing, absolute value is always positive because it is distance. It is not any integer or rational number, it is distance. That's why it is positive. Okay? Understood? Similarly, in the case of rational numbers. Now see, the 4 examples I have written and the question is find absolute value of the given numbers, rational numbers. Okay? So 7 upon 11, what will be absolute value of 7 upon 11? It will be 7 upon 11 itself. Okay. What will be absolute value of minus 15 upon 17? Minus 15 upon 17. What will be its absolute value? Will it be minus 15 upon 17 or 15 upon 17 itself? It is 15 upon 17. Okay. Absolute value is always positive. Here see, find the absolute value of minus 1 upon 3 into 7 upon minus 3. Means here first we have to do the multiplication. We have learned the multiplication of fractions. Same, we have to use here first find the answer and then find absolute value of that product here. Okay? So let's do it. You know how to do the multiplication? Minus 1 into... Okay, first we will make the denominator same. Denominator positive. Okay, this minus sign you have shifted in the numerator. Now multiply minus 1 into minus, minus 7, 7 by 7, negative into negative positive. Upon 3, 3 is 9. 7 upon 9 is the answer. And absolute value of 7 upon 9 is 7 upon 9 itself. As it is distance from 0, okay? Here, there is division of two fractions, rational numbers. So first we have to do the division and then we have to find absolute value of the quotient. So minus 5 upon 4. Division means what? Multiplication by the reciprocal, we have seen. So multiply by reciprocal of the second fraction, 16 upon 35. Yes. So 4 1 the 4, 4 4 the 16, 5 1 the 5, 5, 7 the 35. Minus 1 into 4, minus 4 upon 7 1 the 7. So absolute value of minus 4 upon 7 is 4 upon 7. Okay? Understood how to find absolute value? You know that absolute value is the distance of 0, distance of rational number from the 0. Okay, and so it is always positive, though the rational number is positive or negative. absolute value is always positive. Okay, and every absolute value has two rational numbers. It is one is positive, one is negative, as I told you in the case of 4 and minus 4. Okay, write this for examples in the notebook. Okay, so see now next concept, presentation of rational numbers on the number line. Okay, presentation of integers on the number line we have seen in the earlier classes. How we have located or how we have represent the integers on the number line. See, if this is the number line, here is a point 0. Right, or on the right side of the 0, we have located all the positive integers like 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, right? And on the left of the 0, we have located minus, which is negative integers. Okay, and so on. Okay, now this integers means what? See, all these integers has denominator 1, correct? Every integer has denominator 1. That means these integers are also rational numbers. So, as these integers can be represented on the number line, that's why we can say that all these rational numbers also can be represented on the number line. Or every rational number has corresponding point. Every rational number has corresponding point which represents that rational number on the number line. Okay, so let us see how to represent any rational number on the number line. See now, for your question I have written, represent 2 upon 5 and minus 2 upon 5 on the number line. Generally, we have seen there are two types of fraction. In that, two types which are there, which are proper fraction and improper fraction. So these two fractions, or if you talk about fraction, these two fractions comes in proper fraction, where numerator is smaller than the denominator. Numerator is smaller than denominator. Okay. So if the given rational numbers are proper, means the numerator is smaller than denominator, then how do we present? And in other case, we will see if numerator is greater than denominator, means if they are improper rational numbers, then how to locate them on the number line. So see, first 2 upon 5 and minus 2 upon 5, and in these both the rational numbers, numerator is smaller than denominator. Okay, so how to do that? Draw this number line here in the center of the number line, right? A point 0. Okay. So on this side, right side of the 0, we will locate positive rational numbers, and on the left side of the 0, we will locate negative rational numbers. So first, let us see about 2 upon 5. So 2 upon 5, if we talk about 2 upon 5, think that is it greater than 1 or less than 1? Yes, it is less than 1, because as there is no means numerator is smaller than denominator, and there is no any whole part is not there. That's why it is less than 1. Okay. So what we are going to do? Here we will write 1, 2. Now see, as 2 upon 5 is less than 1, means less than 1. Okay. So the distance between 0 and 1, we will divide into 5 equal parts. Distance between 0 and 1 will be divided into 5 equal parts. So let us do it. 1, 2, 3, 4 and this 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. And now this, from starting from 0, this will be your 1 by 5, 2 by 5, 3 by 5, 4 by 5 and 5 by 5. And 5 by 5 is 1. Okay. So we want 2 upon 5. We have to look at 2 upon 5. 2 upon 5 is here. So make box to it. 2 upon 5. Similarly, minus 2 upon 5. As it is negative, it will be on the left side of the 0. Okay. So minus 2 upon 5 is also here minus 1. minus 1, minus 2, and so on. Okay. So minus 2 upon 5 will come between 0 and minus 1. Minus 2 upon 5, minus 2 upon 5 is less than 0 but greater than 1. Minus 2 upon 5 is less than 0 but greater than 1. That means it comes between 1 and 0. Okay. So distance between 0 and 1 will be divided into again denominator is 5. That's why the distance between 0 and minus 1 will be divided into 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And where will be above? Minus 2 upon 5. Here, minus 1 upon 5. Minus 2 upon 5. Minus 3 upon 5. Minus 4 upon 5. Okay, and here our minus 5 upon 5. And minus 5 upon 5 is minus 1. So our minus 2 upon 5, where it is? Where is that point on the number line here? Okay. So in this way we can locate or we can represent the rational numbers whose numerators are smaller than denominator. Understood? Second type is that. Now pause this video and write this example in your notebook. Let us see the second type where denominators are smaller, means numerators are greater than the denominator. We have example 14 upon 13 and minus 14 upon 13. Okay, sorry, 3, not 13. 14 upon 3 and minus 14 upon 3. Represent 14 upon 3 and minus 14 upon 3 on the number line. Here if you observe these two rational numbers, their numerators are greater than the denominator. Numerators are greater, means 14 upon 3. Okay. So these rational numbers comes in which category? Improper fraction. So first of all, what we have to do? The 14 upon 3, we have to convert into mixed fraction. We have to convert into mixed fraction. Okay. So you know, 40 divided by 3. 3, 4 is 12. Remainder is 2 upon 3. Am I right? 40 divided by 3. 3, 4 is 12. Remainder is 2 upon 3. Similarly, it will be minus 14 divided by 3. That is minus 14 upon 3 will be converted like this. Minus 14 divided by 3. Minus 4 whole. 2 upon 3. Okay. Now this rational number and this we will locate on the number line. Let's draw the number line. Okay, here is our 0. First, let us locate this positive rational number 4 integer 2 upon 3. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1. 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now see 4 whole. 4 complete. Means 4 complete part. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 complete part. After 4, next part is divided into 3 equal parts. What is denominator 3? That means after 4, next part is divided into 3 equal parts. So 1, 2 and 3. So here it will be 1 by 3, 2 by 3, and 3 by 3. Okay? So 1 by 3, and 2 by 3 is here. 4 whole. 4 integer, 2 by 3. This is our number. 4 integer, 2 by 3. Similarly, for negative, again we will divide this into 5 parts. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Minus 4, minus 5. Okay. Minus 4 complete. Okay. So minus 4 is here. And next 3 minus 5 will divide into 3 parts. 1, 2, 3, and here minus 1 by 3 minus 2 by 3. Oh sorry. 1 by 3, 2 by 3, and 3 by 3. So minus 4 whole 2 by 3 here. Minus 4. 2 by 3. So this is our required point. minus 4 whole 2 by 3. So in this way we can represent the rational numbers, two types of rational number, proper and improper. Okay, if it is proper means numerator is smaller, denominator is greater, directly we can that rational number is less than 1, that's why it's easy to locate. But if numerator is greater and denominator is smaller, first we need to convert them into mixed rational number or mixed fraction, and then we have to locate as done here. Understood? Write this example also in your notebook. So today we have learned these four concepts: standard form of rational number, comparison of rational number, absolute value of rational number, and representation of rational numbers on the number line. If you have any doubt regarding this, we will discuss in the problem solving unit. Okay. So, thank you and have a nice day.